Hi all, how are you doing? Hope you're all keeping well. Right, today we're doing a motor vlog on how to get a motorcycle license in the UK, starting from nothing, starting from riding a bicycle, shall we say. So this will apply to all the younger riders, all the 16-year-olds that want to get onto little peds, and upwards to the older people, the over 24s, that want to do a direct access. So to start with, you've got to go and apply for your motorcycle license, which will be a provisional license, and you get that by going on the government site and applying on there. And if you've already got a car license, if you're a 17-year-old that's passed his car test, let's put that up because we're steaming up. Yeah, if you're a 17-year-old that's already passed his car test, you've probably got the motorcycle entitlement as a provisional license on that as well. So you're already covered. But that's not the end of it. You get your license, and then you have to go and book yourself a compulsory basic training course, CBT, which basically is a one-day course which trains you how to ride and control your motorcycle. They hire you a bike for this when it's your first one, and the average cost is around about 120 quid. Well, that's the average cost in my area anyway, in the southeast. You might find cheaper, but cheaper isn't always the best, obviously. Find yourself a decent school that, you know, that's got a good reputation. And you go off and you do your day's training, which starts off in the classroom. You do a little bit of classroom work, and they introduce you to all the safety equipment and crash helmets and IVs gear and all that sort of stuff. And the day proceeds, and you drive around a car park and learn how to move off. Yeah, you learn how to move off and do U-turns and pullaways and round some cones and all that sort of stuff. Thank you. And then you have a 2-hour ride out on the road, out in the big wide world, with an instructor giving you instructions as you go along. So then you've got your CBT, and hopefully you'll come away with a certificate. Sometimes you don't, sometimes they say I'm awfully sorry, you'll have to come back another day for a bit more training because you're not quite up to scratch, but very rare. Normally everyone gets through that on their first go round on that. So you come over with your little certificate, and that then makes your provisional license a provisional license. Without that, you can't ride a bike on the road. But with that, you can now purchase a motorcycle, whether you're 16 and you're getting a ped, scooter, whatever. Or if you're 17 and you're getting a 125, it could still be a scooter, or it could be a geared bike. So that's how the CBT works. So that's the first part of getting on the road in the UK on a motorcycle, CBT, provisional license, job done. Now the next bit is the A1 license. And the A1 license only entitles you, if you pass your test for an A1 license, it only entitles you to ride a 125. Albeit, you can ride it without L plates, you can ride on a motorway, if you so wish, and you can take a pillion, if you so wish. So that's the only entitlement you'll get, and then in my mind, not really worth doing the A1. I would suggest that everyone sits on their L plates for at least 2 years, until you're 19. 3 years if you're 16 and got a ped. Reason for that is, the next step is the A2 licence. And the A2 licence has got some benefits, bigger benefits than the A1 licence. Because if you pass your A2 licence, you can then ride a motorcycle of 47 brake horsepower. I would say that the A2 is worth doing, A1 not really, unless you want to, you know, keep a 125 for a long, long time, they're not really worth doing. A2 definitely worth doing, for another reason as well, because when you've got your A2 at 19, you can then ride, as I said, a 47 horsepower bike, or an A2 class bike, or even a bigger bike restricted. You can have a 650 restricted down to an A2 category. You can ride that for 2 years, and then after 2 years, when you're 21, you can take your A license. Now that's a bit of a bonus, because the guys who want to do direct access, these are the people that have never ridden a motorbike, they have to wait till they're 24. So there's the benefit of an A2 license, is that you can get your A at the age of 21. Which makes sense, because let's face it, if you've done your A2, if you've done your CBT, you sat on that for 2 years, then you've done your A2 and you sat on that for 2 years, you've got 4 years experience on the road on a motorcycle. So there should be some benefit, and there is. The benefit is you can take your A to get whatever size bike you want, get your R1 or Hayabusa at 21. Insurance cost might be a bit different, you know, might tell you different that you won't get a Hayabusa, but that's the advantage of doing your A2 at 19, because then you can do your A at 21. Now the direct access, as I did mention, you have to be 24, minimum of 24, and basically from not riding a bike ever, you can take a course called the direct access. And you start off, you do your CBT, you do a day out on a 125, and then you do the whole test within that course. I think it's probably a 4-day course, 5-day course maybe. Costs a lot of money, direct access, but you can go from never riding one and come away with a license to ride whatever you like. Right, so that's the category, or the categories of license. So how do you actually get to do your test? Well, once you've got your CBT for your 125E, and you've done that for 2 years and you want to do your A2, as I said, I wouldn't bother doing the A1, but that's up to you. First of all, you have to do, the same as you do in a car, you have to do a theory test before you comply for your driving test, your riding test. Now the theory test, you go into a room and there's lots of little booths, and it's you answer, I think it's 50 questions, all multiple choice, pretty much common sense answers. There's a few little curveballs that they throw in to try and catch you out. But generally, if you apply common sense, then you'll get the answer correct. And you have to get, I think the pass rate is 44 or 45, something like that. out of 50. So, you know, it's quite a high pass that you have to get. But you do that, and at the end of that, there's a hazard awareness test on a computer screen. Again, you watch like a video, and you have to click when you see the hazard. You don't click too many times on the same hazard, because you'll lose points for it, but that's a hazard awareness test, and most people will pass that. So there we are. Once you got that, once you got your theory test out of the way, you can then apply to do your Mod 1. You have to do your Mod 1 first, and then you do your Mod 2. Now your Mod 1 is basically a bit like your CBT. Yeah, it's a bit like a CBT. It's in a big car park type area, which is all fenced off, and there's all cones and that laid out in the car park. And you have to prove that you can manoeuvre the bike technically, if you like. It's the technical side of riding. It's some people say it's a waste of time, but I think it's a good idea. Some of it's a bit weird, you know, take your bike on and off the stand and push it backwards into another bay. Then you have to do a slalom course with a figure of eight at the end. Then you have to do a hazard avoidance test at a certain speed, an emergency stop at a certain speed, and you can get, I think it's 5 miners in there, and all the time you're in that area, and it's because they shut the gate behind you and lock it, all the time you're in there you have to ride as if you're on the road, so shoulder checks all the time, every time you do something, shoulder check, you know. So, or lifesavers, whatever you call them. So that's that one, that's the Mod 1, and hopefully you'll pass that and come out with a tiny little certificate, which actually means nothing on its own. Just says you've passed the Mod 1. And I think that's valid for 2 years, as is your theory test. That's valid for 2 years as well. And the Mod 2 is basically doing what I'm doing now, riding a bike on the road with an examiner following you, telling you where to go. So about a 45 minute ride, he tells you where to go from behind generally, and then you have to do an independent ride where he says, okay, can you now follow the signs for centre of London, if you're in London, you know? So you follow those signs and he observes how you ride on your own. You know, if you've been riding from your CBT upwards, you should pass that a piece of cake, really. So that's how you get through your tests. That's how the tests are applied. And once you pass both your Mod 1 and Mod 2, then you can buy a real big bike if you want to. And you're an A license holder. Ooh. And that's it, no more tests after that. Just loads of fun. So I hope that's been of help to someone, explaining all that. I'm sure there's many other videos on YouTube explaining it, but I thought I'd just do my own version. So I hope it's helped someone. I'll see you later. Whatever you ride, ride safe. Ta-da now. Bye-bye.